Welcome back to Pastry Maestra. I'm Tereza, and today I'm making Danish pastry pinwheels. Danish pastry has to be Danish, right? Wrong. Although today known as Danish, this pastry did not originate in Denmark, but was brought there by Viennese bakers in 1850, when Danish pastry workers went on a long-term strike. Danish bakers adopted the Austrian recipes, adjusting them to their own liking by increasing the amount of eggs and fat. This development resulted in what is now known as the Danish pastry. In Denmark, on the other hand, this delicacy is known as wienerbrot or Viennese bread. Weird, huh? Anyway, some sources claim that the original pastry was invented some 350 years ago by Claudius Joly, a French apprentice baker who forgot to add butter to the flour and tried to hide his mistake by folding lumps of it into the dough. Amazingly, the result was the lightest dough ever seen in France. Joly opened a Paris café in 1622, where he served a pastry that the French call a thousand leaves. Later, he moved to Florence, Italy, and repeated his success. Italian bakers took the pastry to Austria, and Viennese bakers took it to Denmark during that 1850 strike. But that wasn't the end of the journey, no. Danish bakers emigrated to many countries all over the world, and voila! So-called Danish pastry is today a worldwide appreciated delicacy. What a journey! Now, if the whole world loves this treat so much, it must be very, very good. So we simply have to make some Danish pastry right now and see for ourselves what's so special about it, right? Let's get to work! As usual, the recipe is on my site and the link is down below. First thing I'm gonna do is make Danish pastry. I've put flour into a bowl of a stand mixer fitted with hook attachment, and now I'll add salt and sugar. I'll start mixing on low speed, and then I will add fresh yeast, cold milk and eggs. Then I'll add softened butter and continue mixing on low speed for a couple of minutes. The finished dough should be smooth. I will wrap it in multiple layers of plastic foil and refrigerate overnight. My dough was in the fridge whole night, so now I will prepare the butter for laminating. I have a sheet of parchment paper that I have folded in order to get 15 by 15 centimeters, which is 6 by 6 inches square. I will unfold the paper and put the butter in. Then I'm gonna fold the paper so the butter is completely closed inside the paper. Now I will pound the butter with rolling pin and roll it so it spreads into a form of a square. The butter should be cold but elastic. Then I will put it back in the fridge for about 10 to 15 minutes. Next thing I'm gonna do is roll out my chilled dough into 30 by 15 centimeters, which is 12 by 6 inches rectangle. Then I will place the butter in the middle of the dough and fold the dough over the butter to enclose it. I will carefully roll out the dough into a long rectangle. Make sure that you always roll the dough in a direction that is parallel to its seamless side. It is important that I distribute the butter inside of the dough evenly, so I'll work slowly. Now I will make a single turn, meaning I will fold the dough into thirds. I will wrap the dough in cling film and put it in the fridge for about 20 to 30 minutes. My dough is chilled, and now I will roll it out again into a form of a long rectangle. Now I will make second turn. I will refrigerate the dough again, and then I'm gonna repeat the process once more. Danish pastry calls for 3 single turns. And here is the third turn. I will refrigerate the dough again. My dough is chilled and now I will roll it out into a 30 by 30 centimeters, which is 12 by 12 inches square. Then I will cut out 9 squares. I will make 4 diagonal halfway cuts and then create the pinwheel shape. I've put my pinwheels onto a paper-lined baking tray and now I will pipe some raspberry jam in the middle. Finally, I will brush the pastry with egg wash. I will leave my pinwheels to prove for about 30 minutes and then I'll bake them at 180 degrees centigrade, which is 350 degrees Fahrenheit, for about 20 to 25 minutes until golden. My Danish pastry pinwheels are baked and now I'll brush them with some simple syrup, which is a syrup made of same quantities of water and sugar cooked until the sugar dissolves. My Danish pastry pinwheels are done and they look delicious. I can't wait to sink my teeth into this crispy delight. Join me!
Oh baby, you are so sweet. So delicious and yummy. So good to eat. I wanna lick you. Feel your sweetness on my lips. Forever and ever, you'll stay on my hips.
I'm Teresa. Thanks for watching my video. I hope you liked it. If you wanna stay in touch, follow me on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. And of course, visit my site where you can find elaborate posts with lots of pictures, additional information and recipes that follow my every video. Also, on my site you can download my free 365 pages ebook, The Pastry Chef, and maybe buy me a macaron, if you think that I've earned it. Now, before you go, please hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. That really helps a lot. Finally, and this is the most important thing, don't forget to create sweetness every day, because sweetness is happiness. See you in my next video. Bye!